Hello and welcome everybody, I'm Proper Variant. This is the Monarch's Journey of Mindaugas. Mindaugas, it literally came out today, just about 4 hours ago, you know, when I'm recording this video, that is. And I looked at the challenges and I said to myself, there has to be an easy way to do this in a very fast time. Now, the first one just requires you to control the entirety of Lithuania while being Catholic and crowned by the Pope. Then, of course, the True Faith requires you to have as many provinces as it is listed there that are Catholic. And last but not least, the difficult one, the long one, that is writing history. You need to have a great library and you need to have book collections in it. Now, I looked at that challenge and I said to myself, that will take about 80 years, if not longer. There has to be a quicker way, and believe it or not, there is a quicker way. Now, what you want to do first is worship the ancestors. By worshipping the ancestors and sacrificing one of your body parts, so don't do the other options, you can gain 100 piety, which will be relevant in a second. After that, recruit all of your troops and take them to the border and then raid Grodno. The province of Grodno is just to the south of you, and you want to raid the castle and then the second holding. And that's it. That should be roughly in October. I know it's very, very specific, but we would be roughly in October once this happened. We just need the raid money, essentially. We don't really care for anything else. You can see I took the castle out, and now we are taking the city down. And with the city down, we are now at a point where the crusade will soon be called. And with the crusade soon being called, we need to swear fealty to Poland. The 100 piety that we gathered by sacrificing towards the ancestors is essentially something that we will be using to become Catholic. And becoming Catholic makes it so that we can join the crusade. Now, what I'm doing right here, as you can see, is I'm just selecting a mercenary band, and that mercenary band is one of the cheap ones. There are ones that cost about 150 bucks, but come with 4,000 troops. You mostly care about the troop count, the amount of troops that you get. And as you can see right there, I have converted. I'm still secretly a Romuva believer, but it doesn't really matter. Being Catholic also means that I can take up a loan, and that loan of course is needed so that I can even finance these mercenaries. Now, as you can see right here, I'm joining the crusade, and having joined the crusade, am now immediately, I want to stress this, I'm taking right away every single one of my troops down here. Make sure that you're selecting, that you're not giving your titles to anybody, and then we can go. So what I'm doing right here is essentially just gathering war score. If you start walking at the exact time that I started walking, so that's about October, November in the starting year, you will be in a position of ambushing the troops of the Sultanate of Rome. And we had amazing tactics here, we were in the defense, this was great, and as you can see, my contribution to the crusade is insane. Yes, we lost the war, of course, or rather we lost the battle there in the end, but it didn't actually matter because the way it turned out for us was very, very, very beneficial. We slaughtered a lot of our enemies, we lost a lot of our troops. You can see I got even imprisoned here, you know, this is not a good crusade for my character, but with that single battle and then a couple of battles where I threw myself away, we effectively were in a position where we are the leaders of the crusade contribution, and that is exactly what you need here. We did swear fealty to Poland, remember, but it means nothing if you all of a sudden were to gain a kingdom tier title, and that is exactly what we are gaining here from the, you know, from the mercenaries that we threw away and from our normal troops. And there you go, we have now become the king of Egypt. There are of course plenty of European families everywhere that are interested in their own interests, but I'll be honest with you, nobody cares for that. We have infinite money, we have infinite prestige and infinite piety, and what we are now going to do is we aren't going to build a library, we are going to conquer one. So I declare war for Arabia, you could go for Hijaz as well, but essentially you want to go via the peninsula of Arabia and just conquer your way towards the House of Wisdom that is in Baghdad, that is under the control of course of the Sunni Caliph of the Abbasids. And all that you need to do here really is just, you know, use the money and use the piety and prestige if you have a holy order at your availability, and use those to go and then conquer Baghdad. You can say it's not really that big a challenge. I mean, it really isn't. I think the biggest challenge in this Monarch's Journey as a whole is, or maybe it's, those are two things. You know, this is going to be sped up for quite some time, so let's talk about the behind the scenes sort of, right? The toughest thing here in this Monarch's Journey, no doubt, is winning that crusade, because the way I detail it to you, I do that on purpose, because otherwise you might not have enough war score, you might not have enough contribution, something might go wrong. You need to become the king of Egypt, and if that doesn't work, just restart. That's essentially the only thing that is quite difficult in this run. Now, the other thing is, and I want to stress this, we are going to do some conversions here, you know, that stuff is going to happen. You can do it without those conversions. It won't be quite as fast. You can see we're conquering very, very quickly here, still as a Catholic, but in a second you will see that we won't, you know, any longer be a Catholic. And that is something that can be locked behind DLC. Being crowned by the Pope as a whole is also, by the way, locked behind a DLC, but don't worry about that too much, because at the end of the day, these Monarch's Journeys, if you don't have the DLC, you will still get enough points, in particular out of this one, because you can do what I'm doing here without any DLC, really. But the way it works is that at the end of the day, if you are interested in doing this without any DLC, I will link a channel in the description, Fool's Gold, that has been doing these Monarch's Journeys without any DLC. I do them with DLC, mostly because, well, at the end of the day, you know, if you look at it, I think it's quite fair to just do the quickest way, even if that means having to have DLC. And there you go, I conquered Baghdad, and just one tick right after we get writing history. That is 6 whole points. If you haven't done any of the Monarch's Journeys, that will give you a neat amount. And you can see I took a screenshot there because I posted it in the CK3 Discord, link also in the description. But you can see that, you know, this instantly did it. And then via province, I just simply converted to Islam, to Sunni Islam. And being Sunni Islam is very beneficial, because with this, we are practically done in the south. You can see I also put my capital down here just so that the mercenaries would spawn in Egypt instead of Lithuania. I still hold Lithuania, but becoming Sunni has multiple benefits. Since we're done with our work here, we only need to conquer some Catholic provinces, and we need to conquer the rest of Lithuania, right? We had this long-term mission of the library. That no longer is a long-term mission because we already did it. And now, as you can see, I'm just bringing my troops up here. And we're just out here now conquering all of Lithuania. Now, being Sunni makes it a bit easier because we have the Teutonic and the Livonian orders right up here as well, which both, you know, you can simply defeat if you're a Sunni by measures of holy wars and or invasions. Now, the thing about being Sunni also has a different benefit. It didn't happen for me here because I didn't actually die, but if you happen to die and you are Sunni, you have open succession, meaning everything stays together, you don't lose anything. If you happen to be Romova, if you happen to be Catholic, then there is a problem with Gavelkind, meaning that you would possibly and probably be losing some of your titles, which is of course suboptimal if you just want to have this Monarch's Journey done as soon as possible. You can see here I'm fighting the Teutonic Order. They will bunch up, they will, you know, gather, they will try to fight you together, but at the end of the day, you should be strong enough. You have practically infinite money, you have so many mercenaries at your disposal, and if you do it well, I cut all of that stuff out, but if you do it well, then so many vassals that want to serve you as well. I just converted my vassals back and forth. All of the vassals in Egypt right now are Sunni, and as you can see, this war just made it so that I am now the king of the Kingdom of Lithuania, which is excellent because, of course, that is exactly what we require. And I just, you know, put my capital back here so that I could summon mercenaries in Lithuania. This is the de jure capital, so that's Vilnius. And then I just continued my conquest. So at the end of the day, the way this works is if you're in need of a fallback option because your character might die, then just go Sunni and you will have open agnatic and you can convert to whatever you want later on. There you go, I just used an invasion against the Livonian Order, meaning that we get everything that they hold in the Kingdom of Lithuania, making it a one war, or rather a one-time war instead of multiple wars. And look at that, I didn't even notice that Pisa conquered Tunisia. And what you can see right here is just some min-maxing, so to speak, where I gave vassals that were strong in Egypt, I can always recommend that if you haven't done it, I gave them land up here in Lithuania, making it so that I can raise all of their troops right away in Lithuania without having to transport them up here. And as you can see, this is working wonders. We are destroying the Livonian Order. Of course, there's barely any resistance. Again, the goal here, after we got the library, that was one full achievement. The goal is to hold a number of Catholic provinces and then the entire de jure area of Lithuania. This is, I believe, the last province that we need, and then we have the de jure area of Lithuania. Now, this doesn't yet give you that achievement, so I was looking at it and I said to myself, okay, I need more land that is Catholic, and I need to be Catholic so that I can get crowned by the Pope anyway. So what I did, and this was quite cocky, I'll admit it, I declared an invasion against Poland. Now that called the Holy Roman Empire, that called Hungary in, etc, etc. I wouldn't recommend that. What I would recommend is that you go against Sweden or whatever. You just need about maybe 4 more Catholic provinces. The entirety of Lithuania that you need to conquer anyway for the second achievement here is effectively already done. Like, you know, I think 4 of those are Catholic, and then you only need 4 more to get Poland done. As you can see right here, we did Poland, and now with that under our control, I hold enough Catholic provinces to get this achievement. We're only missing the one that requires me to rule over Lithuania, as well as, of course, being crowned by the Pope. Now, being crowned by the Pope is actually locked, and by that I mean you need to have Holy Fury. You can see here I was just waiting until the Pope came out of hiding. I think he just died instead of coming out of hiding. Yeah, Pope Stephanus the 10th simply passes away. Just ask him for a coronation if you have Holy Fury. If you don't have it, then don't worry about it too much. The points aren't necessarily worth it. You can simply do other Monarch's Journeys. Now, one important thing that I want to note before we essentially come to the end of this video, and that is just like, what, 22 years of gameplay until we were finished here. He asked me to do an anti-papal war against Castile. If you are doing this, if you need to be crowned by the Pope, he will oftentimes request money or an excommunication war, an anti-papal war. What I would recommend is the following. Before you request getting crowned, simply change the law to free investiture, not papal investiture. Change it to free investiture, because if you do that, free investiture, changing it to papal investiture is what the Pope will request from you, and you can do that immediately. You can see here, I needed to go to war, it took me ages. They were like, I think 3-4 years where I simply was at war with Castile, and they had no shot, they had no way of winning. but you know, it simply cost me a bunch of time. Now that being said, again, the library in Baghdad is something you can get very, very early and easily if you go down there for the Crusades. And then of course conquering Catholic provinces, I mean, they are all around, just go against Poland, etc. If you are Sunni, then you're going to have a very, very easy time there. And other than that, I mean, unifying Lithuania and then being crowned by the Pope. You can see right here, the war is won. And with that, I simply have to click some events away. The Pope says, hey, you're great. And I say, I know. And then all of a sudden, I will be the crowned king of Lithuania. Very Christian, of course. I conquered the entire region. And now all of a sudden, I'm viewed as a Christian king. Is this cheesy? Oh, absolutely. Is this the fastest way that you can gain monarchs points? Absolutely as well. So I hope that this guide was able to help you a bit. And that brings us to the end of this video. And if you have any questions, if you have any interest in this Monarch's Journey or other Monarch's Journeys, then let me know in the comment section. The Monarch's Journeys are very interesting because they give you proper cosmetics in CK3. But with that being said, I would like to thank the members of the channel that are making videos such as this one possible, namely the Barons, Stefan the Pelted, Achilles, Know-How, Eterna, Falling Phoenix, Jacob, the Musialago, Dan, Florian, MFA, Mitchell, Aaron, Stefan, Snywolf, and Trangili. Then, of course, also the Counts, Lockton, Kazen, Wombat, Thomas, Shiftir, and Rex Romanorum. And last but not least, the absolutely beautiful Dukes, Eric, Kiriana, Goodfield, Nathan, Jack, Kenneth, Lexo, and Larry Soloing Pixie. Thank you all so much for supporting the channel. I really do appreciate it. If you also want to support the channel, then check out the join button right underneath this video. With that being said, later, alligator.